Now, we get to a major issue that I've never discussed before, and it's the concept of the she-male, and this is major. As you know, in this society, there's been a deliberate attempt since slavery to destabilize the natural feminine and masculine principles in the household. The European has effectively emasculated the man and masculinated the woman. He has effectively reduced us to a subservient role of almost a feminine posture, and at the same time empowered the system to the point where she is actually running the black community. Now, this has always been largely reinforced by the fact that there's been an all-out war on black men. So as a result of that, black women have had to stand up and run the community, and the sister has done an excellent job of doing it. But it didn't cause a problem historically because men knew sisters had no choice but to do what they did, and sisters really didn't have a problem sharing power with the man when he came back into the house. However, in the post-civil rights movement, there has been a deliberate attempt to take the masculination of the female and the emasculation of the black man to another level. And so white supremacy has deliberately sought to do what? Educate, empower, and employ black women. Educate, empower, and employ black women. So right now in America, we are the only race where the women make more than the men, where the women have more education than the men, when the women are more socially, economically, and politically empowered than the men. Is that a problem in and of itself? No, it is not, unless the black woman allows herself to be morphed into a European alpha male. A female is the traditional black woman. That's the original black woman. That's the sister who does not consider herself to be beneath her man, behind her man, or in front of her man. She's beside her man. That's the female, the she representing the feminine principle. But we also have to deal with the she-male, Sister Nikki. That's S-H-E-M-A-L-E. How does the she-male differ from the female? The female, that's the traditional, original black woman, empress of the universe. But the she-male is a sister who has the body of a woman, but the psyche of a European alpha male. Let me say this again. A she-male is a black woman who has allowed herself to be used as a weapon of oppression against black men by white men. She has the body of a woman, but the personality of a European alpha male. And as you know, two men can't rule the same kingdom. So when a sister allows herself to be conditioned into becoming a she-male or having the psyche of a European alpha male, now she comes home and she wants to do what? Treat the black man the same way the white man treats the black man. And the black man can't take it. And as a result of that, brothers are rebelling. Brothers are walking out on marriages. I had a brother call me last week. He said, "Brother Umar, I've been married for 10 years. We got 2 children. But ever since she got this doctorate degree, brother, I don't have a say-so in his house. She's telling me how she don't need me anymore, that she's the main breadwinner." And he said she's always made more than him. But now she
Tell her to call me up. I say now. Go ahead.
Now she has the doctorate degree, Sister Nikki. So now, guess what? She's morphed into the European alpha male. She's no longer a black female. She's a black she-male. And no black man with self-respect is going to allow himself to be psychologically castrated in his own damn home. And that's a big reason for why not all, not most, but a lot of our educated black women cannot find suitable black men, because men are not going to allow you to tyrannize them with your education.